Hey, you. I actually date people. No, so you see, whenever I see people, I walk fast, and whenever I see people on the streets walk really slow, I look at them and I wonder why, and then I see they have their phones on. They flicker on their screens, they swipe, they scratch, they whatever the fuck they do, they text on their phones. And I just wish at that very moment the boss would come from somewhere and just smack him and kill him. That usually gets a reaction. This is probably a positive room. So, you know, it's like in Final Destination, whenever something, if you saw that movie, just randomly people die in that movie. So if they were to talk on their phone on the zebra walk, just the boss would come and just smack them, kill them, just like that. We'd make the news, make more news than the acid tax, and I mean, that's for sure. But I can imagine that, you know, nobody else would say this thing. But one day I was in the shop, I was just walking through the shop, I looked at something and I said, you know, I'll buy it. So I bought that thing from the shop, I left the shop, I took my phone out of my pocket to put how much I spent, because I'm organized like that. And then it hit me. I'm a motherfucking hypocrite. How many people would tell you that they're hypocrites? Exactly. Everybody is a hypocrite in some way or shape or form, but nobody would come out and say it. It would be like the Americans that are living in closets, you know, like gay guys, because in America it's a big oppression. So it'd be like the Americans living in the closets, and they're just coming out and say, you know what, I'm gay.
Everybody would be like,
you're so brave, man. It doesn't matter that in Europe and everybody else, everywhere else, people have been gay for centuries and came out as gay. But in America, you're such a brave thing for coming out as gay in the 21st century. It's amazing. The second thing is, those people that are in the aisles in supermarkets, you know, they walk and they stare at products on the aisles. It doesn't matter if they've seen the products through the aisles like 25 million times. They just stop and stare and they just look at them and think, well, this has a different label, doesn't it? This has a different ingredient. And then hit me. I'm a motherfucking hypocrite because I do the same thing. I stop at the aisle and I look at digestive biscuits and I say the same thing. Maybe they don't have palm oil in them now. Turns out they still do. Maybe the ketchup has actual tomatoes. Nope, still puree. The next thing is tobacco. You know, those motherfuckers that just smoke tobacco, smoke puff. Not pass, just puff. You know what I'm talking about. Just puff, and they're smoking next to somebody who doesn't smoke, and they're just nonchalantly filling the other person's lungs. And then, no, it didn't hit me because I'm not a cunt. I don't smoke either. I mean, that's a shitty thing to do, you know? Like smoking somebody else's face. You know, so you're punching your face just because I feel like it. But you smoke in my face because you feel like it. That's not a nice thing to do. The fourth thing is coffees. Now I find coffee is a bit like racism. At first you have black, because we are all black. No matter what somebody else might tell you, we were all black. Regardless if you're from KKK or not, we were all black. So at first you had black coffee, then you decide to add a bit of milk, you know, like maybe like a latte or something, and that's okay. So, and then you had cappuccino, frappuccino, mochaccino, fattuccino, and yaduccino, alpacino. Then you had mocha, coca, come in your face, latte, whatever fancy thing is in the shops nowadays. And then it hit me. But before that there was an espresso. Or as I like to call them, dwarfs, midgets, or the people that refuse to grow up. And then it hit me. I don't like coffee. I never had coffee, so don't hit me. It didn't hit me. I like making coffee, but I would never have it because it's horrible. It smells disgusting. I don't know how people can have it now. And then there's the fifth thing. Number five. Hipsters. Now, you see, hipster, the word came about roughly 10 years ago. And when hipster hit the floor, like, every girl was like, ooh, yeah. Like, fucking, they never saw a guy before. Fuck me, man. See, I'm a vegan, and if I was a vegan 10 years ago, every pussy was on the floor next to the vegan. But now every pussy is on the floor next to the hipster, because they have an owl in the nest of the beard. They have a MacBook backpack with a MacBook inside. They have a flat top, and they have a lumberjack shirt that makes them look like sort of a man, but not exactly a man, because they're more of a pussy than a girl. If I were to have a lot of money, I'd make Titanic 2. I just set them on a voyage to the iceberg, wherever, and I hope they die. Or better yet, I just send them to the Bermuda Triangle to find the aliens, or to find the Atlantis, or the Kraken. I mean, anything. And then I was about to hit somebody because he called me a hipster, but he was too far away, so I couldn't go after him. If I could have, you would have seen a body floating in the Thames. Acid attacks, car crashes in the museum, and bodies floating in the Thames. Those are the headlines of today. So, there was a song that said, you're once, twice, three times a lady. You're once, twice, three times a cunt. If you identify with those things.